In the last few sections of this chapter, we're going to look at some of the qualitative examples of how gases behave. And there's mathematical quantitative equations behind this stuff. But what we're going to focus on here is the outcomes of those mathematical equations instead of actually trying to solve those mathematical equations for like mean free path or the van der Waals equation, which is for non-ideal gases and things like this. We're just going to look at the results of the equations, and that's kind of what you're going to be responsible for here. So what do we want to talk about here is molecular size and pressure, and we've alluded to this before. In a gas, the molecules are constantly in motion, and they're exerting pressure by bouncing on the walls of the container. Gas molecules, and all molecules, are incredibly tiny, but they can exhibit 14 pounds per square inch. If you remember back from a few sections ago, that's like putting a bowling ball on a 1 square inch tip of a thumb, for example. So that's quite a lot of force. Well, how can they do that? Well, how they can do that is there's lots of molecules. So lots of molecules bouncing into something can exhibit a lot of force, even though individual molecules are tiny and can't exhibit much force. But an interesting thing is that at the same temperature and amount and volume, so if the temperature and moles and volume are constant, number of moles, then small molecules like helium and large molecules like xenon exhibit the same force on average on the walls of the container. Now, this is not to say by any means that every molecule exhibits the same force, just that the average is the same. If you think about the SATs, there's an average score on the SATs. That doesn't mean that everyone gets the exact same score. So it's the same with molecules. So here we're looking at the average, even though we're showing only one molecule, because I can't draw a lot of molecules, but we're thinking about the average speed. So let's say this helium and this xenon hit with the same amount of force to the walls of this container. Well, how is that possible? Note, there's the same amount of helium, the same number of moles, and the same number of moles of xenon. So it's not that there's more heliums than there are xenons, such that they can increase the force. What it is the heliums, which are much smaller and much less massive, are moving more quickly on average. On average, the heliums are moving faster. Therefore, they can exhibit the same force. The xenons are, on average, moving slower. So when they exhibit the force on the walls of the container, even though they're much more massive, the force is the same because they're moving slower. It's sort of like a crash test into a wall. Maybe a compact car is moving 25 miles an hour when it hits the wall, which would exhibit the same amount of force as, say, a big truck moving at 10 or 15 miles an hour when it hits the wall, because the truck is much more massive than the compact car. And it's the same idea here. Well, this has some important physical effects that occur because the helium molecules or the smaller molecules are moving on average faster. And one of those effects has to do with diffusion. Diffusion is essentially gases or all molecules desire to move from high concentration to low concentration. So if there's a high concentration of gas released, you know, in the corner of a room, let's say someone quickly opens a helium tank. Initially, there'll be a lot of helium in the corner of the room, but eventually that helium will spread out and mix uniformly throughout the room, assuming the room is sealed, of course. If the room is not sealed, it should, in theory, move to the entire world and spread out evenly over time, of course. So that's how diffusion works. But because helium is moving on average faster than something like, let's say, oxygen, it's going to diffuse faster because its molecules are moving faster. So let's look at what we have here. Here we have hydrogen, the smallest molecule, and oxygen. So when we initially start this with a closed stopcock, we see that this is all hydrogen and this is all oxygen. When we open the stopcock and we see what happens, the white hydrogens, many of them, move over to the oxygen. And only a few oxygens move over to the hydrogen. Both of these have a desire to spread out, to mix evenly, and go from an area of high concentration to an area of even concentration. However, the helium can do it more quickly, or excuse me, the hydrogen can do it more quickly. And the reason that the hydrogen can do it more quickly is because at the same temperature, pressure, and amount of moles, on average, the hydrogen is moving much faster because it's smaller. So since it's moving faster, it can diffuse more quickly. Over time, they will mix evenly. But initially, in point B, you'll have a point where the hydrogen is more spread out than the oxygen for the reason that those molecules are on average moving faster. If we look at another property, which is called effusion, this is the transfer of gaseous atoms or molecules from a container to a vacuum through very small openings. So basically this opening has to be the size such that one atom goes through at a time. If you have small molecules that are moving faster, they'll move through this hole more quickly than large molecules, which are moving slower. So small molecules can effuse more quickly than large molecules because they're on average moving faster. And there's actually a practical example of effusion that you may be familiar with, and that's in balloons. The rubber or plastic that these balloons are made out of is not a completely impenetrable surface. It also has these small holes which gases can escape. So if we start off with equal-sized helium balloon and air balloon, shown here, I'm not sure why the helium balloon isn't floating, but we have the helium balloon and an air balloon. If we look at some later time, and this is a different view, the helium balloon will get smaller because the helium balloon's molecules can effuse through those holes more quickly than the larger molecules found in air, which are larger molecules like nitrogen and oxygen, which are much larger than helium. So helium balloons tend to shrivel up more quickly because the molecules can effuse more quickly. So this looks at the practical implications of fusion and diffusion of molecules based on their size. And the take-home message is, small molecules, on average, at the same temperature, pressure, and amount, move faster. Therefore, they can effuse and diffuse more quickly.